Let me show you the perfect solution for your webinars. It's called a live webinar, and it's great for influencers, teachers, exhibitors, product launches, whatever you want to do that's going to be live. This is going to be your solution. So let me show you what I'm talking about right now. There's so much to cover on live webinar. The first thing I want to get started with is an actual webinar to show you how powerful it actually is. So I've started my test webinar here, and I am actually viewing this from three angles. So first of all, it's obviously me, the presenter, which is George Aguilar. I have Al Pacino as my incognito window over here watching the webinar as I am doing it right now. And I also have my Android phone, which is my phone right here. And it's also, I'm showing you the screen recording right now of this actual webinar. Now, what can I do with this? I mean, a whole lot. Aside from just showing you my camera here on this webinar, I can actually add more type of views inside of this system. I can have them previously ready before actually going live. So that means that if I have something in my storage that I want to present, well, I'll just go ahead and see what I have, and I'll select this one. Here we go. Present. I'm gonna select it. And it's a previous video that I uploaded. I have that ready to go. I also have ready to go a video from a video link that I have, and I can just click play on it, and people who are watching my webinar, they can actually view it. I also have this previous survey that I created, and it's just, I named it this you pay attention. And if I select that, the viewers will have the option to vote on it. So did I pay attention? Well, I'm gonna say yes for this, and then I'm gonna respond to this. And as I respond, I'm actually getting the results over here. Same thing goes on this one. So this is Al Pacino watching the video, and I'm gonna select this, gonna send it out, and I should be getting the response for this. So, okay, people responded, I'm good to go. I'll continue my webinar, and I'm still continuing. And if I, for some reason, found out that I need to mention something in a meeting or a webinar, classroom, etc., I also have the option for a whiteboard. Whiteboards are super cool because sometimes you can explain something with like voice, but they won't understand it. Like, let's just say I want to draw something. So I'll have this whiteboard and I select, you know what? I need a house that looks like this, okay? And this house needs to have a big window like a modern house. I don't want a typical house, and I want it to have a big door like this and have a little handle there. So kind of give it that little modern look, but I could explain it, but they won't understand it. But if I draw it, it makes it super easy. So having that whiteboard there makes it fantastic. And just like that, there's several options available here to present on your webinar. I won't go through all of them because there's a whole bunch of them. So you check those out. Now, aside from presenting, we actually see the presenters here. We have a chat. So if someone chats here, you can actually go ahead and say something. So let's just say hello on this phone, and I'm getting it over here. I'll go back to the webinar on my phone, and I'm viewing it over here. And obviously, since that message was in the general chat, I can view it over here on my incognito mode as Al Pacino, okay? So all those options are available. Now, if you need to change settings, right now I have it muted because I don't want it to loop around the audio, but I can unmute it, turn off the camera, change different views. As I change it, everything goes. I can lock the webinar, I can change, make invites. So if I wanna invite right now someone by email or copy the invitation link, I just do so here. So a lot can be done on these webinars. So basically I wanted to show you the power of all this before I jump into all these settings. Okay, so this is your live webinar dashboard, and this is where we're gonna get started with the previous setup before actually going live. So let me go ahead and close everything over here because I'm done with the webinar. And to schedule a meeting, you have a lot of options. First of all, I recommend that you previously set up a couple of things before you actually go live, like presenters. First of all, create your presenters, especially if you're gonna have a webinar, we have several people, add a new presenter here by adding all their information there, okay? Then you have your call to actions. So for example, this was just a test I created, and I'll go ahead and edit it just to show you. And you can make these presentations by audio, text, or something like that. So in this case, I created an audio.
Help me out by sharing this webinar. Thank you.
Okay, and it's just gonna be presented for 5 seconds. I can enable call to action on this. And just like that, I can create more actions for that. Also, I can create tests and surveys. These, like I said, it's good that you create these before you actually create your webinar. So in this case, I've made these three. One's a test and two are surveys. So the one you saw in this video was the test. So the test, what they do is that they actually provide a score for it. So that means that I can create a poll. Well, my bad. I want to create a test right here. Okay, and this is just a test. And the time, I'll set it to 3 minutes, and the percentage of points needed to pass, randomize questions, and add questions. So I can add the question, answer, and set the points for that particular answer, and obviously get a score for it. So again, set all those up before you get ready to make the webinar, okay? Now, how do we create a webinar? Let's go into Room and Events. I have two options. One is the instant meeting. This is fantastic when it's actually meetings, right? So it's not like a webinar. You don't previously tell people that you're gonna go live in a certain time, etc. This is just a meeting, like one-on-one or as many people as you need, but it's a meeting. So it's super easy to create. Next we have is the scheduled webinar. You have three options. One is the scheduled, where you actually select a time frame, and anyone who joins that link that you send out, it's only going to be available once you start that webinar. Then you have the permanent webinar, where it's just open room, where if they jump in, it's available, okay? And then you have the evergreen webinar, where you actually pre-record a video or a video from YouTube, etc., and you can stream it, okay, with this evergreen webinar. Now, if you decide to go this route, when you make these videos, you have to make them in a way that you actually make people think that it's live, because if they know it's a pre-recorded video, they might go away. So just kind of like a tip there, okay? Let's do a scheduled one. So I'll just name this test. Won't tag it for now. The starting time will be tomorrow at, I don't know, a.m. Okay, duration, 45 minutes, time zone, set that up. And this is just a test webinar, okay? I'm gonna schedule it. And once I schedule, I have all the options available. Now, this is where all the magic goes into previously setting up your webinar. Now, inside of here, I can go ahead and view the summary. I can view the room address, the invite participants. So if I go to invite participants, it's gonna open up a page where I can go ahead and send email invites at the emails here, or copy the invitation link and just send it out. So you have those options available. You can join, embed. So if you have a website and you wanna embed it there, go ahead and do it, add to calendar, delete it if you made this by mistake. The participants, all this information, your invitation, browser address. So if you're going to send an invite to attendees, you're going to use this one, all right? If you're going to invite moderators and presenters, copy these different links, okay? Then we have the basic settings for this. So if you want to change it after you've created the scheduled webinar, if you want to make it permanent or evergreen, go ahead and do so. The presenters, you can go ahead and assign presenters to this. Registration, if you want to start up registration, you, in this case, it's set up to no form. But I can design a new form and ask them questions like their name, their email, and whatever I want to add here at the next fields. So that would be the best route to do so. So they register and they get notified when the webinar is going to start. The appearance, if you want to change the appearance here, go ahead and do so. Design new template and update it. Room background image and room banner image. You have your tracking information. That's going to be on the business package. Paid webinars, if you're gonna set this up as a paid webinar, obviously, and security settings. So if you wanna make password protected room in case you wanna share a password to particular participants just to make it more secure, you can do so by enabling this and setting your password. The waiting room, if you wanna enable this or not, coding belt, double encryption, account tokens, and all that good stuff, and the advanced options for this. So a lot of options are available to set up your webinar. So you decide everything you need before you actually go live, and once you go live, it's gonna be an easy breeze, okay? So you have your discussions, raise hands, classroom, which I showed you already, the room layout, room template, notifications, before, after meeting, and everything right there. So just like that, it's super easy to schedule a webinar. If you want to create an evergreen webinar, don't forget to upload the recording first, unless you want to use a YouTube or Vimeo video. To do that, just go ahead, go to Room Events, schedule webinar, select the evergreen, and you can select the recordings that you have available. Remember, they're over here. And if you wanna use YouTube, go ahead and insert the link here or Vimeo. And when that is scheduled and good to go, it's just gonna stream that video for you as an evergreen webinar. So it's a really useful tool to have it available here. And if you want to create an instant meeting, just go ahead and click on instant meeting and you're good to go. Now, tell me that's not easy. So if you wanna start doing webinars, live webinar is a great option to start. I thank you all for watching. Don't forget to check out this deal in the link in the description, and that's a wrap.